Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video if you need to remove or replace intake or exhaust camshaft position sensor on BMW F30, F31, F34. As you know, this is the 3 series guys, generation from year 2012 to year 2019. Now before we start, let me guys introduce you to the channel quick. Every single car we get at the shop, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos, but specifically on this BMW we will have close to 500 videos. Why we do that? Because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can, guys. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information. Now something else, if you need to buy new camshaft position sensors, any parts, tools guys for your car, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get all our tools and parts from. Now we do that guys so you can see, okay, where you can find cheap parts with fast shipping as well. This is the car right here. We have the intake air filter box removed out of here. Why? Simply because guys, it will be a little bit in the way to show you how to do things, but practically you can do it without removing the intake air filter box. But if you need more room, the video will be on the channel how to remove air filter box assembly on BMW F30. Check it out. Before we start, check this thing out guys. That's our second channel, Electrical Car Repair Life. We'll be sharing videos about diagnostics, engine codes, electrical systems, things like that on that BMW. So very helpful information will be shared there. So we'll go ahead, remove the upper engine cover. Okay, and again, if you want to see how to remove the air filter box, you can check it out, it's on the channel. We'll remove that foam piece, okay. You have to be careful not to break it. That thing is easy to break, so don't just yank on it. It can get hot here on different lines, so it can break it. Always gently pick it up and pull it out, guys. So, once you guys come right here, let us explain, okay, what we need to do. That wiring harness, we're going to just pull it out, okay, from there, so we can get a little bit more room. And now, if you come down here guys, okay, that's for the variable timings, that's the phaser, also known as adjusters. And on the bottom side of your engine, okay, that sensor here is a camshaft position sensor, and you have another one over here, that's a camshaft position sensor too guys. Two camshaft position sensors. How we know which one is in intake, which one is exhaust camshaft position sensor? On the left side of the engine, facing the engine, you have the exhaust manifold. On the exhaust manifold side, that's the exhaust camshaft position sensor right here, and this one is the intake camshaft position sensor. So tools that we'll need to actually remove the sensor, okay, I believe it's this one. It's called a reverse Torx 8, I believe it is. Okay, let's see, and we'll just demonstrate how to do that on one, but the procedure actually to remove and replace both will be exactly the same guys. Also, we'll have a special video on the channel that will explain how to test a camshaft position sensor, so definitely guys, check it out. It will explain everything about testing them, how to know if it's good, how to know if it's bad, and all that stuff. So here we'll need to grab an extension, okay, so we can come down a little bit lower, and that way we will be able to remove it, otherwise it will not work out. Another thing guys, be prepared to actually have a little bit of an oil leak. Why? Simply because there is oil and there is a ring that actually prevents oil from coming out, but you can actually guys still leak some out when you remove it, so you will see what I'm talking about. So we get in there, careful not to damage things. You need to just get in an angle. Okay, let me show you now. Okay, so we got it in. If it doesn't fit, what you need to do, just get a little bit of a shorter extension. Okay, you can pull it now out. Okay, due to the fact that now guys, okay, the bolt will go by hand most likely. Okay, check it out now. So we just go ahead and unscrew that bolt, and we can probably do it by hand only at that point. Okay, check it out. Now it's very important not to drop it. So when I'm ready to pull it out, okay, it's very, very limited room. And you just want to take your time there, okay? Don't rush things. Okay, this is the bolt right here. It came out. Now the sensor itself, okay, it will be stuck, guys. Okay, it will be stuck. We're going to grab it, okay? Don't twist it. Okay, you can come a little bit with a screwdriver and pry between the cylinder head and the sensor. Straight. Come out. You may leak some oil out. This is the sensor. Now we need to disconnect it. How we do that? With a small screwdriver, there is one tooth that you need to lift up a little bit. Not too much, because you will break it. Okay, that's a bad screwdriver. We need to get a little bit thinner screwdriver next time, because it cannot go in there, guys. Okay, you can see this is actually pretty thick screwdriver. It needs to be very thin, fine, and don't bend that piece too much, because if you do, you will actually break it. Okay, perfect, like that. And you pull the camshaft position sensor out. Okay, and we'll have a video how to test the camshaft position sensor on a BMW on our channel. That's the intake side. Exhaust is practically in the same way, guys. And putting it together is in reverse order that we took it apart. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching, and see you guys next time.